Yeah. Let me know if we are live and let me know who is watching right now. I'm actually streaming live directly from my Zoom here because this is actually where we are usually for our fit camp. Okay, so I just want to make sure everybody can hear me. Okay, I just want to be sure that everybody can hear me and see the image that I got here. Beautiful. And feel free to write in the comments if you're tuning in live and you want to join me or you just want to sit on your couch and watch me work out. Okay, so today is our workout day. And here, look, Purple Life represent. Okay, I'm going to show you guys what are some of the whole body toning workouts you can do at home with simple equipment. Okay, so today we are using some equipment and everything we're going to be doing here is going to be simple, fun, and easy. Okay, so all you need is a resistance band. So I got this really pretty one here. It's not super, super tight. So I know resistance bands actually come in different grades. You can get your easy ones, which are very stretchy, or you can get the hard ones with higher resistance. Okay, so I know a lot of you guys like to work out from home these days. You may not have all the room and the access to all the equipment. So a very, very good one for you to have is to have the resistance bands at home. It's better if you have different grades. I have two types at home, so this is like the easier one for today because I don't know, I feel like, you know, doing something that's not too hardcore. So we're gonna be needing the resistance band today for the toning workout and also a pair of light or medium dumbbells, okay? So this one that I got here is about, let me see, 2.5 pounds each, okay? 2.5 each. So this is ideal as a lightweight. You know, like some of you guys can go as light as 1 pound, 1, 2, 4 pounds, that's considered pretty light. 5 pounds above, no, 5 pounds to 10 pounds, in my opinion, is medium. All right, so it really depends on everybody's strength. You can see these ones are pink. I don't know, maybe they designed them to be for girls, but you know, just letting you guys know, we'll be needing a pair of light dumbbells and also a resistance band for our total body confidence toning fit camp today. Okay, so it won't be too much. We're gonna go through basically body parts. We're gonna be working on our upper body, our arms first, and then we'll be working on the lower body with a resistance band. And then lastly, we're gonna be needing the dumbbells again to work on our core, to work on our abs. And then we're gonna finish up today with a really amazing fat blasting Tabata. Okay, so if everybody's ready, let's get started. Okay, let me know who is watching, who's following us. I know it's not very often I come here live to do a workout with everyone. Yes, I can see quite a few of you guys watching. Yes, we're streaming straight to you from Zoom because inside my Authentic Energy Fit Club, we have everybody joining inside the private Zoom. But I want to give you guys a taste and a little snippet of what is it like to do a live workout with me, okay? Before you decide if you want to join me in the club, if you want to get my coaching, you know, you get this taste here and you can listen to my music as well. All right, so we're going to start warming up. Just do a quick warm up. And today's workout is not going to be a long one. Usually we do 1 hour, but today we're just going to keep it around, you know, half an hour so that everybody can, like, you know, get a workout out of the way and go enjoy your weekend. Okay, so we're going to do a live warm up. Move your body around just to basically move the joints around so you don't basically just snap yourself straight into the workout, because a lot of times if you don't warm up, you can injure yourself. Okay, right, so stand on the spot and just move your arms, windmill style, back. And give me a big smile, right? It's the weekend already. I don't know how many of you guys here have that weekend mentality. Oh yeah, TGI Friday. Hands in front of your chest, rotate, rotate. Every time when I get to move my body, whether if it's by myself or with you guys, I'm in my happy place. And I'll tell you what, I'm in the happier place when I'm able to move my body with other people. I'm a people person. I love being around people. I'm an extrovert. So when I'm able to exercise with a bunch of you guys, it makes me extra, extra happy. Okay, and then reach up just to elongate the spine and the arms. Just a gentle, I don't know what we're doing. We're probably doing some aerobic style warm-up, right? Well, we actually call this dynamic warm-up. dynamic warm-up means dynamic stretch, means we are not holding any poses for a long period of time, but we're constantly moving. Okay, now, hands together, foot out, round your back. Good, and to the back. And stick your chest out. Good, squeeze your shoulder blades, squeeze your arms together, beautiful. Hands on your waist. Okay, and tilt your head to the right, to the left, to the right, to the left. And do a little bit of rotation clockwise. And anti-clockwise. Oh yeah. Good, and to the front, to the back. Front and back. Beautiful, beautiful. Now come back here and roll your shoulders back to the front. Beautiful. And now we're going to do a little hip circle. This is an oldie, Where Have You Been by Rihanna, from like 10 years ago, something like that, right? Or maybe less. Okay, anti-clockwise. Very nice. We're doing slower pace today, but we're adding a little bit of fast pace, fat blasting at the end. Okay, now I want everybody to give me some lunges. Okay, step back. Okay, hands on your waist, step forward, the other side. Okay, alternate your legs, step. Yeah, yeah. Okay, step side to side. Beautiful. Oh, actually, I gotta be careful, especially I'm streaming this on YouTube and I'm playing like copyrighted songs. YouTube is gonna get me in trouble. I totally forgot. See, I don't usually stream this. We keep this private. That's why I don't have to worry about the music. Okay, I just got reminded. YouTube's gonna send me an email and tell me about copyrighted music. Okay, come back. Shake it up, shake it up. Okay, just a quick warm up. Now we can get started. Okay, you know what? Just in case if YouTube cuts me, I'm gonna have to play something else, all right, just in case. Okay, I'm gonna have to play like non-copyrighted music. Okay, let me see. Okay, not on Spotify. I wanna be responsible, so that's why everybody please bear with me. I don't wanna get in trouble with YouTube, so I am going to go YouTube creators music. Yes, did you guys know that there's a lot of music from YouTube that you can actually go and use without worrying about the copyright? So this is what I have to do. And this way, when you play the music, especially to public space, you will not get in trouble, okay? Right, beautiful, beautiful. No non-copyrighted songs. Okay, beautiful. Okay, let's try this one, okay? See how it goes. Okay. I don't know what the tempo's like. I don't want you guys to wait for me forever to look for a song. I think it sounds good. Dance and electronic comp. Okay, let's go with it. All right, so first exercise, we're going to be using our dumbbells. It's gonna be very simple. Okay, I will need my timer out here too. Let me get my timer out here. We're gonna be doing two exercises for the arms back to back. Okay, the first one is basically a very simple overhead press. Okay, so overhead press. Oh, it's kind of sexy, the music. Okay, and the next one, just simple overhead press. Okay, you don't have to do anything fancy, but make sure you keep your elbows up. You don't drop your elbows when you come down. Keep your arms parallel to the ground and press up. This way you have more control. Great, beautiful. And the next one, with the same lightweight dumbbells, we're gonna do some punches, jab and cross. Okay, jab and cross. So when you're adding the resistance, the weight, this actually helps you work harder. Okay, so jab and cross, jab and cross. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. So we're gonna do 30 seconds each, and I'm gonna shorten the break, just 5 seconds of break, so we can switch and speed up the workout. And we do 3 rounds in total, okay? At least 3 rounds in total. And this is how you can get the best workout, the best result out of it. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, overhead press. Let's go. I kind of wish the dumbbells a bit, you know, heavier. Everybody's different, right? So I want to be able to show you guys how even with the lightweight, you are still able to tone up. Beautiful. Down, up, down, up, down. Okay, those of you who are joining me from home, and those of you who are part of my Fit Club, you can come into the Zoom and join me right now so I can see you. Beautiful. Now, drop it. 3, 2, 1. Punches. You can set your stance. If it's easier for you to have the fighter stance, right? You just have to gently bounce. You're not really hopping, but just make sure whatever punches you like to do, jab and cross, all you need to remember is you're actually utilizing more of your muscles because you've got the weights in your hand, right? If you do feel like better, feel free to move around, okay? So it's not boring. Move around a bit more. Move around. Beautiful. Okay, that's the bell. Okay, again, round two, overhead press. Overhead press, beautiful. Oh, this is a very nice background. Okay, remember not to drop your elbows. Don't dip your elbows. Control. And you know what? Sometimes you may feel like you want to go heavier. You may underestimate some of the lighter weights. But once you've done a lot of reps, you will start to feel it. Actually, your body will really start to feel it after many, many reps of light weights. Okay. All right. Second one. Let's go. Punches. Maybe I should change my stance, right? Just to kind of like mix it up a bit so that your body is not always in the same stance. I like to change it up, but essentially it's still the same exercise. Punch. Punch. Yeah, let me get a close-up shot here so you guys can see me. Okay, great, beautiful. Some of you might be wondering, all right, now round three. Some of you might be wondering, you know, how come my camera quality is different? Because I actually have three different cameras at home. Right now what you are seeing is my laptop camera, which I use a lot because I do a lot of work in front of my computer. And also the second device that I use for filming is my cell phone. I have a Huawei Pro 20, P20, which is quite outdated. I know they have P40 out now. So I may upgrade my phone very soon. And the third device I have is my camera, my Sony camera. All right, now punches. So lately I haven't been using the Sony camera much, but well, actually, the last video you guys see here is actually filmed on my Sony. Okay. Woohoo! Come on. Give me that big smile. I'm very happy because I'm live here with you guys. And some of you might still want to see me live at 6 o'clock because I know a lot of you guys here have that date with me every Friday, 6 o'clock, right? I will still go live. I'll do a very different live right after this. And I'll make it a separate episode. All right, we are done. Woo, woo. Beautiful. So have a quick relaxation for your arms. Just quickly shake it out. Some of you who may be using heavier weights, you know, you might find that your arms get quite sore. So just give it a quick break. Okay, next, we're gonna be using a band. Okay, let me check and see if anyone has left any comments or anything like that. I know this may work differently when I'm streaming straight here from my Zoom. Okay, beautiful, beautiful. All right, let's come back to it. All right, now we're gonna be working on our lower body. So we're gonna go the back-to-back, the same back-to-back style. I'm gonna start my timer again. 30 seconds each. Okay, and just back to back and three rounds. First one, we're going to step our feet into the band, cross the handle. Okay, if you want to keep the handle at the waist, put it up. It'll be great so it's easier for you to control. And the first thing you need to do is a squat and then come up. When you do a squat and bounce up, you can already feel the resistance from the band, right? So, but that's not all I want you to do. Squat. When you come up, you want to do a kick. So you can take your right leg up and do a kick, and take your left leg up and do a kick if you want. But you know what? Just to keep it simple, let's do a squat, come up, and just one side kick, and back. Down, up, and kick, and back. Yeah, so when you're doing that back kick, you can feel that nice gluteal muscle contraction, right? So this is where you're training your butt to be stronger, okay? You're toning up your butt, you know, to have the nice peachy butt. But also, our goal here, you know, as a body confidence coach, let me tell you, our goal here is actually not to create that nice body shape or anything like that. The so-called nice body shape will be there as a result of you working on your body, working on your health, working on your confidence, all right? So the more that you're working on the strength and the toning, the muscle strength of your butt, the bigger your butt will get. Like, bigger butt means healthier butt, means healthier body. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. This is a really good butt workout. Okay, so kick one side at a time. Okay, keep your body balanced so you don't go, whoa, all right? So how do you keep your body balanced? Contraction, contract and tucking the tummy as well. All right, so this is the first one. And then the next one, we're gonna keep the same band cross formation, but this time what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a lateral walk. So you keep your body nicely squatted. Okay, three steps to the right, three steps back. All right, so this one is also really good for your glutes, but also you're working your quads as well. All right, so keep your body down. Don't bounce up and down, all right? So this is our two workouts for the lower body for today. Your butt is gonna thank you for this. And tomorrow when you wake up, when your butt is sore, you'll be thinking about me in a good way, okay? All right, guys, so let's get started. 30 seconds. Start with a butt kick first. And let's go. Down, kick, down, kick. Beautiful. Down, kick, down, kick. Oh yeah. See how fun and simple the workout is? Especially when you're doing this with me live. That makes a big difference. And very often I hear from a lot of you saying that, oh, I get so lazy, I'm not motivated to work out. This is where you have to stop and ask yourself, what is your end goal? Okay, and if your end goal is that you do want to lose weight, stay down, three steps. Okay, stay down. If your end goal is you want to lose weight to improve your health because your doctor tells you to do that, or maybe you feel like you can keep up with your kids, you need more energy, then you know that your motivation will have to come from the fact that you want to be there for your family. You want to live longer, right? So what you must do, you must change your lifestyle. You must change your eating habits. You must change your activities, your active lifestyle. All right, so back to the first one. Down, kick, down, kick. So you have to establish your motivation, your why, really clearly. You know, you can do that with me if you got me as a coach, or you can do that with another person, your coach, or with yourself. But I'll tell you what, usually when you do that by yourself, it's not strong enough, because a lot of times you can't see your blind spots. You think that's what you want, but then very often, what you tell yourself is not the real reason. The real reason is not for you. It's what, not whatever that you established to be. Two, three. Okay, keep your body nice and low. So when you are able to access a coach, then you're able to get another person's view, especially a professional person's perspective on what needs to be done, what needs to be changed. Because if it's just you telling yourself what you need, that is not enough. That is why a lot of times people just don't bother. You know, you feel like it's so hard to keep up. But that is because you don't have a real drive, real motivation for you to do anything. So, you know, not doing anything, sitting on the couch,
is simply a reflection of how important you think your health is, or how important it is for you to move your body at this stage. Maybe for some of you, if it's not, then you're gonna be okay with that. And you're gonna be okay with the fact that if there's inaction, a lack of action, what consequences would you get? All right, nice. This is gonna be our last one. Lateral walk. Get your body down. 1, 2, 3. Back. 1, 2, 3. Keep your body down. Oh yeah, I am still going. Don't stop. Yes, we're almost there. Another 15 seconds left. Yeah, it kind of hurts when I'm not wearing the shoes because I'm at home, right? So I keep my feet bare. It feels nicer, more natural. Let me know in the comments if you also bare your feet like that. All right, we are done for the lower part. Give me a 5. You guys have done so well. Super, super awesome. All right, oh, I can really feel it in the glutes. So give it a really good tap, massage, because your body deserves a bit of a quick break. We're gonna do some like nice stretch to stretch out the glutes. Now, finally, we're gonna be working on that core, okay? So I'm gonna take out my mat. So you guys will need to have your mat down on the floor, unless you have, I don't know, carpets or some kind of material that doesn't require you to have the mat. But, okay, that is the problem. When you play some music from YouTube, they show you the ad. Okay, so go back to your dumbbells. Okay, we're gonna be doing 2 back-to-back again. All right, the first one. You're gonna be holding your light dumbbell, your lightweight. Everybody can see me, right? And you wanna be able to come up and fold and crunch and have your right hand and the leg touching. And then go back. So you alternate the hand and then left hand, right foot. Crunch. Crunch. All right, you guys got that? Yeah, that's it. That's simple. Right, so what is the difference between normal crunch and this crunch? Well, you're gonna be using your arms. That is why we start with the arm power first, right? And then with the weight, it adds that extra resistance. So you have to actually utilize more body muscles to crunch and to engage. Okay, let me adjust the mat a little bit. Okay, perfect. Now you guys can see my whole body. And then the next one, we're going to flip over, put the dumbbells down. We're gonna quickly come over and we're gonna do a little roll, renegade roll. So get your body in the plank position. Okay, 1 hand each side, hold on to your dumbbell. If your dumbbells have like round edges, you cannot actually hold them like that, not in a stable way. You can put them down and have your hands inside. Okay, and what we're gonna do is we're going to do a little arm roll, one side at a time. Okay, you can do this. Gently place the dumbbell down. If you are able to hold them in your hand, it's just a lot more convenient. Okay, lift up, lift up. Right, so you're working on your core and you're working on your triceps. Okay, this is our second one. Right, now you guys see how we're doing the 2 back-to-back, working the same muscle groups, but with this one, you're also utilizing your upper body. So which is why we were gearing, we're actually preparing for the upper body by working on upper body first. Okay, everybody ready? We got the core and the upper body together, and on my mark, we got 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Up, down. Yes, oh, I love this music. So soothing. Crunch, down, find your own rhythm. All right, everybody's rhythm is different. Maybe not everybody can follow my pace. That is completely okay. Just go at your own pace. All right, and crunch. Down. Just think about what are you doing to your body right now. You're being responsible for your health. You're taking action to make your health better. Okay, and roll. Let's go. You're only doing 30 seconds. You'll be over before you know it. Make sure your butt is not sticking up. Make sure your back is flat. your whole body is flat, in a straight line. Alright, engage. Tucking your tummy. Don't let your body sway or rotate. Okay? So really engage the hips. Everything's in the center. We're almost there. Alright, that's the bell. Let's quickly come down and get into a crunch. Up, down, up, down. Very nice. Woohoo! Oh my god, this is awesome. Feels so nice. Oh yeah. Come on, keep going. And up. Alright, remember to breathe. Down, inhale, out, inhale. Beautiful, everybody. Flip over your plank roll, okay? One side at a time. Find your own rhythm, okay? You can go slower if that suits you, if that allows you to stay up longer and stronger, and then you have to allow your body to slow down. Come on, team. We got this. One side at a time. One and two. Do this for body confidence. We're doing this to build high self-confidence. All right, relax. Oh yeah, round three. Let's go. It's like there's no break. Only enough time to switch position. And that is why it's awesome, because we're gonna be done very soon. Okay, keep your legs straight. Crunch up. Bring your whole body up. Very nice. Very beautiful, everybody. Forget about your body shape. Forget about your weight. Right here, it's about you and your body. You're doing 100%. You're giving your body 100% love. And that is what you're doing. Okay. Beautiful, everybody, let's go. When you're working out, I don't want you to keep looking at the mirror and judging yourself. That is not what we're doing here. We're here to give ourselves love, 100% body love, self-care, self-love. That is why you brought yourself here in this space to work on your body confidence together. And that is what I'm doing here, to help everybody. And that is the bell, everybody time. Woo! How are you feeling? Awesome? Exhausted? You want more? Let me know. You must be feeling it here, 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 everywhere, right? So we're gonna do a quick stretch. Everybody come down onto the mat. Tummy down, lie down, palms by your chest, and gently press your body up. Very good. Inhale. Exhale. When you exhale, the oxygen, the chi goes into your spine, your lower spine. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Beautiful, everybody. Exhale, bring your body down. Very nice. Okay, have your both arms out. Good, and just relax here. And walk your palms back. Nice and slow. We're going to slowly peel our body off. And then walk into the child's pose. Very beautiful, everybody. So nice. And just feel the nice opening your hips. And also give your lower back the nice stretch, the nice pressing. How are we feeling? Now slowly bring your body up. How is everybody feeling? Are we feeling awesome? Beautiful. So, you know, working on your body, doing the whole routine, doing the total body routine is actually part of the body confidence building process. But you know, only the exercise alone is actually not gonna do the job, which is why a lot of times we do a lot of mind training, like mindset training, the reprogramming up here, the subconscious reprogramming.
That is the bigger part, actually, because body confidence is not about, you know, how much you change your body, how much you enhance the physical appearance. It's all about how you view yourself on the inside, right? So we're going to end today's session with one final 4-minute Tabata workout. Okay, those of you who have never done Tabata before, basically Tabata is a type of high intensity training and interval training. So basically you have 8 rounds and each round of workout is only 20 seconds. It's only 20 seconds. And between each round, you get 10 seconds of break. So basically your heart rate goes up like crazy and then you drop it very quickly and you raise your heart rate up again. So that is why, you know, it's working in an interval style. And Tabata is really effective fat burning, a very effective fat burning workout method. So which is why if you search online or something like that, you'll find a bunch of Tabata workout, right? And I personally love Tabata workout because it's very fast, it's very effective. But I do have to say that it's not suitable for everybody. So if you've never done Tabata or any kind of high intensity interval training before, I do suggest you to kind of like slow down and be cautious, all right? Because a lot of times people can get dizzy, you know, if they suddenly jump straight into something high intensity that they've never done before, right? So while I'm talking, I'm just gonna set my timer to 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Okay, and in total, we have 8 rounds. Okay, so with the 8 rounds, what you guys can do is you can pick one exercise and repeat it 8 times. Or another way that you can do this is something that I do in class a lot is you can actually pick 2 different types of exercises, okay, and then you just alternate it, which means each exercise you do for 4 rounds only. So split it into half, so you have 2 workouts, right? But for today, we're going to do just 1 exercise and we're going to repeat it 8 times. All right. So I want everybody to challenge yourselves. I want you all to like push your limit because I want you to like show yourself. I want you to prove to yourself that this is how far you can push your body. Okay. In a champion's way, in an athletic way. All right. And that is the purpose of today's workout here. All right. And those of you who are interested to do some kind of sexy heel dance, the little dance with me, do let me know so I can make some videos for you guys, because that is something that we do inside our BCM program. And a lot of our girls are really in love with it because doing stiletto and heel dance is a great way for you to feel awesome in your body, for you to feel empowered, for you to feel feminine. That is beautiful. That is a 100% yin yang balance with a fitness workout. Okay, so we're gonna jump straight into our Tabata. And the Tabata we're gonna do just 1 exercise for today is, okay, take it easy if it's your first time doing it. Okay, we're gonna be doing mountain climber, right? The good old classic mountain climber, 8 times. Shall we challenge it? Yes, we shall. Okay, so when you're ready, let me see. Okay, yeah, just leave the music here. I was gonna change the music, but I thought, okay, copyrighted thing. All right, so let's do this, everybody. And just listen to my bell and let's go. On the ground. Kick your knees up. Kick your knees into your chest. Okay? I should cut back all my talking because I have to do 8 rounds of this. So I don't want to run out of oxygen. Left, right, left, right. Good job, guys. Keep running. Beautiful. So this is round 1. You can have a quick rest. Okay. And then we're going to get into round 2. Altogether, only 4 minutes. All right, let's go again. Number 2, mountain climber. You can find your own pace. All right. What I usually do is I speed up towards the end. So I have some energy for the end instead of going crazy at the beginning and then run out of energy towards the end. All right, beautiful. Set your body down, catch your breath. You do want to push yourself for as far as you can, as much as you can for the 20 seconds. Let's go. Round 3. It'll be over very soon. Just don't think about it. Enjoy the process. Let's go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. You got it. You got it. It's only 20 seconds. Beautiful.
See? Woo! Catch your breath. Woo! This is real time, man. If I fail, then you guys will see it. Okay, round four, let's go. One, two. Make sure you're breathing. You work with your breathing too. Try not to stick your butt up. Keep your butt nice and low. All right, done. So that's number four. We're halfway in already. Just wanna check. Yes. Number five. And let's go, everybody. Only 20 seconds. You can do this. Easy. Easy peasy. Okay. Come on. I'll let you know when it's the last 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, everybody relax. We got how many more to go? 3 more to go. Okay, so if you need a gentle quick massage, let's go. Number 6. So I want everyone to go super fast with me for round 7 and 8. All right. Steady. All right. Keep your breath together. Keep yourself together. And time. Beautiful, guys. This round, number 7. Let's go a little bit faster, shall we? Crank it up a bit. Okay. Push it. Really push it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go as fast as me if you can. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Double the speed. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo! That was crazy. I was almost losing my mind. Like, sometimes when you go too fast, you just can't keep up, right? Last one. Let's go, team. Go fast. Come on. I told you to push it. In the end, champions, winners run through the finish line. We're gonna finish this. Come on. Another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time. I love it when I hear that bell. How did you guys go? Let me know in the comments. Let me know in the chat. How was it for you guys? Are you dying? Or are you feeling like that was just a scratch? You can do more. Let me know. Regardless how you went and how you're feeling, I want to give all of you guys a big round of applause. You're all champions. You have done so amazing. And I know that we have almost gone over time, but remember, you always have to cool down after your workout, right? And because of the time limit that we have today, I'm gonna take you guys through 3 crucial cool down for everything that we've done today to stretch some of the main muscles, okay? Firstly, why are you still kneeling now? Left leg out, hip flexor stretch. Dip your hips down, push it down so you can feel the back leg getting that nice hip flexor stretch. Good. You can bring your arms down on the ground, or you can bring them inside. If you want to go deeper, drop your body onto your elbows. Oh, that feels so delicious, doesn't it? Beautiful, everybody. Okay, now slowly rise up. And I want everyone to try this. You can hold on to something, or if you are able to balance, kick the back leg and use your arm to grab it. So it's kind of like a yoga-inspired king pigeon stretch. So when you're doing this, you're actually deepening the hip flexor stretch, and also you're stretching your quads in this way. And also you're opening your chest and also your shoulders. So basically one stone, many birds here. All right, and slowly let go of that leg and slowly sit back into your back foot and straighten your front leg. So now you wanna feel your hamstrings here. Okay, so both palms here, inhale. Exhale, bring your head towards your knee.
Yes, feel that nice, delicious stretch of your muscles. Work with your exhalation. Every time you exhale, your muscles relax a bit more. Okay, inhale, come up. And we're going to swap our legs. So right leg forward, left leg back. Okay, same as before. Drop your hips down. Now, because I'm switching sides, you guys can't see. Okay, it's just the same as before. Ooh, I can really feel that my left leg is a lot tighter than the right leg. So this may happen to a lot of you, that you might find that one side is a bit tighter or less flexible than the other one. So you need to be very mindful of how much time you spend on the tighter side, because ideally, optimally, you want both sides to be balanced, right? You don't want to have like one side that's like super flexible, the other side that's like super tight, because when you have that kind of imbalance in your body, this is when injuries can occur very easily, right? So this is something I want everyone to pay attention to. If you want a deeper stretch, drop down onto your elbows. Very nice. And keep breathing into your spine. Keep breathing out and melt your body down. Okay, now slowly push your body up. Same as before. Kick your back leg up and reach back with your, if it's left leg, reach back with your left arm. You want to feel that nice opening of your chest and your shoulder and your arm. So you're stretching that part, but also you're stretching your back leg, your back hips, and your back quad. Inhale and exhale. Oh, so beautiful. I can stay here all day. One more. Inhale and exhale. Slowly let go. Gracefully, both palms down. Bring the right leg back. We're going to bring our body into down dog. Down dog position. Try to bring your heels down. So this way you're stretching your calves, stretching your hamstrings more. Inhale and exhale into your feet. So beautiful, everybody. Okay, now gently walk your palms towards your feet. Walk, walk, walk. And just hang there, relax. Let go of all the tension. You all have done so amazing today. Slowly inhale and exhale. Inhale, slowly come up. Gather all the energy around you. And exhale, bring your palms together. Come back to your heart center. Okay, now I'd like to bow into all of you. I want to bow down to your beautiful divine energy. Bow down to all of your amazing effort for following this workout today to work on your body confidence and to work on your health. Okay, so those of you who are here for the first time, my name is Jean. This is Authentic Energy Body Confidence Coaching. Every week, I am here to give you guys the best tips to help you become healthier, happier, and more confident. And I am here to help all of you guys to go from body conscious to body confident in a simple, fun, and healthy way. All right, I don't believe in anything that is only purely based on body image. As a, you know, health and wellness and former weight loss coach, I do not want to coach anybody based on the fact that you want a new body image. Because if your focus is always on body image, on the image and some kind of beauty standard focus kind of result, your confidence will never be there for the long term. You'll only get a temporary confidence. What we're trying to do here is to help everybody build a long-term sustainable confidence. Okay, that confidence does not depend on whatever your body looks like. It does not depend on what kind of makeup and dress that you wear, but it depends on your belief and how strong you are from the inside. Okay, thank you so much, everybody, for following today's special Fit Camp Body Confidence Fit Camp live workout. And if you like what you see here, if you want more confidence coaching and nutrition coaching, herbal life coaching from me, feel free to join my Authentic Energy Fit Club. Okay, you should be able to find the links in the descriptions after I come off, and then I'll put it all in. All right, so get in touch with me, send me a DM. Any questions you have, let me know. All right, thank you so much, everybody. I'm gonna go live again, maybe shortly in about half an hour, all right? Because every Friday at 6 p.m. I go live, but today's a very special. I just decided to jump on here live and share some of my workouts with you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and thank you so much. Enjoy your weekend. Love you.